In a time when information is so plentiful that it's nearly overwhelming, there are some artists that are inspired by data and brandish it as an artistic tool, just as any researcher must do. An artist starts by collecting data that they wish to express. Now, it could be anything that interests you, really. You could dig through websites or books to find records and statistics like weather patterns or demographics. You could record data from just observing what's going on around you. Count how many cars go past or how many brands of soda there are on a store shelf. You could interview people to collect personal information, such as a favorite song or maybe their favorite type of candy. Now, this is all data, and it can be expressed visually. For instance, I've collected data about earthquakes occurring in 5 states. So I have 5 sets of data, including the number of earthquakes in a month, the strongest earthquake that day, the strongest in the last 30 days, and then the top magnitude earthquake that entire year. Now, you'll notice most of this is numbers. Data is almost always expressed in numbers first. Here's something we're very familiar with, expressing numbers in a bar graph. So here's a bar graph that shows you the number of quakes in each state in one day. Here, I've taken a piece of gridded paper and colored one square for each earthquake. Now, this is the same exact set of data, and I've assigned each state a color. Sometimes data is expressed as parts of a whole, as we're used to seeing in a pie chart. This pie chart tells us out of how many states, which one had the most earthquakes in a month. Now, we don't know exactly how many earthquakes, just who had the most. So on a graph paper, I've created a zigzag pattern. This tells us exactly the same thing. Data can also be expressed in overall size. For the strongest earthquakes during the month, I chose to do a triangle shape. California had the strongest, so they have the largest triangle. And the other shapes are smaller. Another way to express data is with color intensity. This time, I cut a hexagon from gridded paper for each state. Now notice how Alaska is solid blue. That's because they had the strongest earthquake that year. Now the strongest earthquake in Texas was only 4.0, so that hexagon is mostly white. We've expressed all this data in colorful patterns. Now, what do we do with it? How about making a collage? My gridded paper was a little lightweight, so I attached my designs to a piece of cardboard, just using a glue stick, and then cut out each piece. You'll want to arrange the pieces, a little like putting together a puzzle. It may be best to arrange them first before gluing them down permanently. As an option, you can raise some of the pieces from the surface by placing something beneath them. If you look inside this piece, you can see there's 3DOs. They're little foam buttons, and they have adhesive on each side. You just peel and stick them. Now, it's up to you to decide whether you want the viewer to be able to read the data that's in your design. You could provide a key that tells what each pattern means, or simply allow the viewer to just enjoy the design. I can tell by looking at this piece that California is the earthquake capital. If you'd like to turn the data that you collect into something as visually exciting as this, go to dickblick.com. We have the gridded paper, a great selection of markers, and a free PDF of this lesson plan available for you to download.